لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين، وأصلي وأسلم على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد بن عبد الله الهاشمي القرشي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول تبارك وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم، أو كما قال صلى الله، أو كما قال تبارك وتعالى. Respected viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. Welcome to another episode on the sublime conduct of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the noble Anbiya عليهم السلام. May Allah تبارك وتعالى make us among those that will lead the life of the Anbiya عليهم السلام, of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those that will practice upon the life of the Sahaba. For indeed the Quran al-Kareem says, radiyallahu anhu wa radu an, that the Sahaba was such creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such beings of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala been pleased with them, and they were pleased with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steady and steadfast, inshallah, on this life. For indeed, we know in the life of the Sahaba, the life of the Anbiya alayhi wasalam, in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the salvation. Every Nabi to come, from Adam alayhi salam until Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, every Nabi to come, you know, the life was so sublime, so pristine, subhanallah al-azim, that if humanity and insan look into their lives and start learning their lives and educating to others, Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely give us success upon success upon success. In today's second episode on the sublime conduct of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Anbiya alayhi wa sallam, inshallah we'll be speaking on, you know, a lot of people ask the question that before speaking about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was Muhammad? Who was Muhammad? Where did he hail from? A little on his life, inshallah. Thereafter, we'll be speaking on what Islam is about, what Islam teaches us, what is Islam. And throughout the three episodes, inshallah, while we'll be speaking on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, speaking about Islam, we'll be speaking about the characteristics and the akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as we know it. Remember the Quran al-Kareem, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, in the noble Quran, in the holy Quran, in the Quran al-Kareem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed, you are the most loved, and you are the most noble, and the highest in character, subhanallah al-Azim. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most loved and noble in character. When Aisha radiallahu anha was asked one day, that what was the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did she mention? كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ, his character was the Quran al-Kareem. Do you not read the Quran? Asking the Sahaba. His character was the Quran al-Kareem. So he was a living example of the Quran. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala sent the Quran down to humanity as an instruction manual. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it out for us to open it up and see in there how can we learn a lesson and lead our lives. And the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the Quran that was revealed unto his heart as a living example to show us how to use the Quran like how he used it sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So inshallah, in three parts today, speaking on these three different topics: who Muhammad was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what Islam is about, what is Islam, what is Islam. A lot of people ask the question and want to know more of what Islam is about. So we'll be speaking of what Islam is, lughatan, shara'an, you know, according to Islam, what it stands for. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us follow Islam, inshallah, fully. And at the same time, the characteristics and the akhlaq and the character of the noble master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inshallah. To all those viewers out there, remember, inshallah, you can follow us on our Twitter account, that's Hamad6HAMMAAD6, or you can like our Facebook page as well, inshallah, for all those that are following us. Inshallah, remember, speaking about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad bin Abdullah bin Abdul Muttalib bin Hashim bin Abd Manaf bin Qusay bin Kilab, subhanallah, his entire lineage goes on. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal, Amul Fil, the year of the elephants. Now, the year of the elephants meaning what? You know, before the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abraha, a king from Yemen, wanted to destroy the Kaaba, the Baytullah in Makkah al-Mukarrabah. And Abdul Muttalib, who was in charge at that certain time, the people came and told him, Ya Abdul Muttalib, Abraha intends destroying the Kaaba. So subhanallah, he said, the owner of the Kaaba will take control of the Kaaba and look after it like I am looking after my shepherd and my sheep and my goat. Subhanallah al-Azim. Abraha intended to destroy the Kaaba, and he came towards Makkah al-Mukarramah with an army of elephants. Now imagine, even if elephants coming to a certain place, they would actually stampede and destroy the entire place within a couple of minutes and hours. The creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abraha proceeded towards Makkah al-Mukarramah with intention of destroying the Kaaba. In that same year, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. When he came towards Makkah al-Mukarramah intending to destroy the Kaaba, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala sent ababil, swallows, small little birds with little tiny pebbles in their beaks. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلِ. The entire ayah of the surah of the Quran was revealed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do you not see what Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala done with the people of the elephants? When they came into Makkah al-Mukarramah, the end of the Makkah al-Mukarramah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala sent ababil, birds, tiny birds, in the skies, millions of them, they threw down pebbles from their beaks and it came down like a gunshot. Allahu Akbar. It entered the elephant from the top and exited from the bottom. This was the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala destroyed them within seconds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's army and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's creation, we can never ever play with. Remember, the army of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the unseen, when they come, they come. So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, the Kaaba. Inna awwala bayt wudhi'a lin-nas lil-ladhi bi-Bakka mubarakan wa hudan lil-alamin. The first house built was in Bakka, the Kaaba. It was built for the hidayah and guidance of mankind. Subhanallah al-Azim. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make us among those that will visit Kaaba very, very often, Baytullah very, very often. May Allah make us fond of the place, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us love Haramain Sharifain. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala take us now and again, inshallah, to Makkah al-Mukarramah and Medina Munawwara. Taking a quick break, inshallah, when we come back, we'll be speaking on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who he was. You know, like we spoke earlier on, born in the year of the elephants, and much more on the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Stay tuned.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب. لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Welcome back to the second sector of today's episode, alhamdulillah, speaking on the sublime conduct of the Anbiya alayhim as-salam, the pristine conduct. You know, there's no words to mention how pristine and sublime the akhlaq of the Anbiya alayhim as-salam, the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. Allahu Akbar. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give us such character that when people see us, they feel automatically in their hearts inclined towards us, inclined to what we are teaching. For we see the entire world today in so much of corruption, bloodshed. You know, we should be among those, like Islam teaches us, you know, peace upon peace. From the time we are created, from the time we meet people, it's only peace. Assalamu alaikum. Peace. May peace be with you. Islam. Peace. So subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep that in our heart. So that when people see us, they feel inclined towards us. And when we see people, we win them over. you know, to the beautiful deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna ad-deena 'inda Allah al-Islam. The deen in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala chose for the people, for the masses, was Islam. Now, speaking about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abraha came with his entire army before the outskirts of Makkah al-Mukarramah. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala destroyed the entire army, and all the elephants were destroyed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Kal al-Bakka and Makkah al-Mukarramah from the clutches of the oppressors. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep on saving Makkah al-Mukarramah from the hands of the oppressors, inshallah. Abraha came into Mecca before Mecca and he was destroyed. Now, so in the very same year, known as Amul Fil, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal, Amul Fil. Now, do we know what Amul Fil? It means the year of the elephants. Meaning the year when Abraha and his army was destroyed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were intending to destroy the Kaaba, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, built by Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim, which we'll be speaking about inshallah, who was the father of two nations. And you know, subhanallah, as the Quran al-Kareem says, Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanita lillahi hanifa walam yaku min al-mushrikeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Ibrahim alayhi salam and the entire incident. We all know that, you know, Qurbani is coming, and Qurbani is founded upon the teaching of Ibrahim alayhi salam as well, and how when he wanted to slaughter his son, make dhabah and Qurbani of his son Ismail, when he told his son, I see in a dream that, you know, I am slaughtering you. You know, so what's your opinion? And he tells his father, oh my father, do as you are commanded by Allah, and you will see me among those that are patient. Now just imagine, this will be coming inshallah too soon, very, very soon. So he was born in the year of the elephants. Now in this very same year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so just imagine the amount of sacrifice and patience he went, and calamity that he went through in his life. Before he was born, his father Abdullah passed away. At the age of, subhanallah, so when his father passes away, he was born. And you know, after being born, the Arabs at a certain time would have a habit to send the kids out to be a foster, you know, breastfed by another woman. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was breastfed by Halima Sa'diyah radiallahu anha. At the age of 6, when he comes back home, on his way back to, subhanallah, he and his mother, while visiting, his mother takes ill in Abwa, and his mother passes away. Amina, his mother passes away at the age of 6, a young child. They were visiting, and in Abwa, his mother took ill, and she was buried in Abwa. Abwa is a place between Makkah al-Mukarramah and Medina Munawwara. At the age of 6, he goes into the care of his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, who was his paternal grandfather, the father of his father, Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib loves Muhammad with all his heart and his life and his soul. For 2 years thereafter, from 6 to 8, he was in the care of his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib loved him. At the age of 8, Allahu Akbar, his grandfather's demise takes place. Just imagine, a young child. No father, born without a father. When his mother is born, when his mother is gives birth to him at the age of 6, his mother passes away. At the age of 8, goes to his grandfather. His grandfather dies or passes away. And thereafter, he goes into the care of his uncle, his father's brother, Abu Talib. And now his father's brother, Abu Talib, is basically his backbone, his support throughout his life, even after he becomes a Nabi. Unfortunately, he never accepted Islam, but he was his backbone. Abu Talib loved his nephew very, very dearly. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, throughout his life, you know, before accepting Nubuwa as well, he was a business person, a tradesman. And he went with his uncle Abu Talib once to Sham, and with Khadija radiallahu anha's worker once to Sham as well. And subhanallah, because of his truthfulness and what he had in him, Khadija radiallahu anha actually proposes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam while she is 40 years of age and he is 25 years of age. And he accepts gladly, subhanallah al-azim. And why does she propose? Now this we should bring in our minds, because he was truthful. As-saliq al-ameen. He was a truthful one. He was very, very truthful, subhanallah. To such an extent that she saw all her business dealings boom, and every cent that was taken account for, that it was there, subhanallah. So Khadija radiallahu anha saw his truthfulness, and she proposed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he accepted gladly. and thereafter he marries her. So just imagine that a lady coming to a man and proposing, asking for his hand in marriage because of his truthfulness, as-sadiq wal-ameen, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thereafter, we know that he goes to the cave of Hira, which he done very, very frequently in his life, going to the cave of Hira, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even before he got nubuwa and prophethood, worshipping the Lord of Abraham. One Allah, the creator of the skies and heavens, my nourisher and your nourisher, the creator of humankind, of human creation, of every single thing on this earth, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, is to worship him in seclusion. And this is where he is to go. One certain day when he went, the archangel Gabriel comes unto him, like he came unto Jesus and Moses before him. May peace be upon them all. Gabriel, Jibreel alayhi salam, comes unto him and says, Iqra, read. And he says, Ma ana biqari, I cannot read. And he presses him. For the second time, he says, read. And he says, Ma ana biqari, I cannot read. And he presses him. The third time, he says, read. And he presses him, Ma ana biqari. And he says, Iqra, bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read in the name of thy Lord who has created you. Subhanallah. And thereafter, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam obviously shivers and he runs down the mountain top with fear in his heart. And he comes to his wife, Khadija radiallahu anha, and says, cover me. And you know, she covers him. And inshallah, you know, after the break, we'll be speaking more on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how she comforts him. And what does he do? And from this stage, Nubuwa starts off. Taking a quick break, inshallah, we'll be back shortly. Stay tuned.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب. لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to the third sector of today's episode. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala make us praise him in every condition. May Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala keep us with iman. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala make us praise Allah and make his tasbih and tahmid and takbir in every condition that we are in, inshaAllah. Alhamdulillah, we spoke about the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before the break, we concluded and stopped where his wife Khadija radiallahu anha comforted him. Now, Sayyidah Khadija radiallahu anha, the first wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never ever married until she passed away. Another woman until she passed away. That's how much he loved her. Allahu Akbar. He goes to her and tells her, Zammiluni, Zammiluni, cover me with a blanket. And she covers him. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, out of the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sends the ayah and the surah of the Quran down, Ya ayyuhal muzammil. That, oh, the one who has covered himself, Ya ayyuhal muzammil. Just look at the love Allah tabarak wa ta'ala had for his habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she covers him. And thereafter, she takes him to, you know, her uncle Warqa bin Nawfal, who is a very, very learned person, or one of her family members, Warqa bin Nawfal, who is a very, very learned person. And she goes to him, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says his entire incident to Warqa bin Nawfal, tells him what happens. And Warqa says, Ya Muhammad, verily you are the chosen one. And oh Muhammad, the same angel that came to you is known as Gabriel, Jibreel alayhi salam. And he visited you, and before you he visited other prophets as well, like Abraham and Moses and Jesus, may peace be upon them. And oh Muhammad, your people will turn you away, and they will chase you away from town. And oh Muhammad, if I live to be in your time, I will gladly accept you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Warqa comforted him and told him of who he was, the chosen one. And remember, as the previous books, the Injil and the Torah and the Zabur speaks about the coming of Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was told by Warqa bin Nawfal that you are the chosen one. And this is how the Nubuwa starts off. So this was the Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A person who had peace his entire life, who went through hardship his entire life, from before he was born, his father passes away, his mother passes away, his grandfather passes away in his life while he's in it, you know, he's a child. And in the same year, while he's a Nabi, while he gets Nubu at the age of 40, just imagine, Aamul Huzn, the year of sorrow and the year of grief, in the very same year, the uncle who gave him all the support while he was, giving da'wah ila Allah, calling the people to the oneness of one Allah. And his wife on the other hand, Khadija radiallahu anha, both of them leave this world in 1 year. Abu Talib leaves this world, and Khadija radiallahu anha, his support, you know, his support on the right and support on the left, both of them leave this world. Amul Huzn, known as the year of sorrow. They both leave this world. Imagine, you are a person that, you know, goes out to call people and giving them, you know, da'wah ila Allah, and everybody mocks at you and laughs at you, and the same way, you know, people are done to him in Taif, and the same year, his uncle, who is his support, and his wife, both leave this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy was upon him, you know, that year. So just imagine that a Nabi, who being afdal al-khalq, being the most respected among Anbiya alayhim salam, akram al-rusul, and the most honored of all Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation, goes through all his calamities in his life, hardship in his life. Remember the Quran al-Kareem, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created life and death. Why, respected viewers? So that he may test you, to see which one of you is the best in character, in actions, in a'mal. إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا إِبْتَلَى. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves you, what does he do? Allah puts you through a test. Allah puts you through a test to see how you react. Do you react with flying colors, or do you react in a manner that is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pleasing to shaitan, the devil? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test his Nabi. Test upon test upon test. So remember, the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought Islam. Islam meaning, subhanallah, submission to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One who submits himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a Muslim. Islam, lughatan, means something that submits itself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muslim, that creation or that thing that has submitted itself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So shara'an, Islam means, you know, based upon bunya al-Islam wa ala khams, shahadati an la ilaha illallah. Islam has been built upon five pillars, shahada an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, that to testify that there is no God but Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the messenger of Allah, iqam al-salah, to, you know, to uphold the salah, wa ita al-zakah, to give the alms charity, wa siyam ramadan, to fast in the month of Ramadan, wa hajj al-bayt, and to make hajj, in istata'ta ilayhi sabila, if it is, you know, in your means and capability. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us among those to make hajj, inshaAllah. Iman mufassal in mujmal. Iman mufassal in mujmal. What is Iman? Amantu billah, I have faith in Allah. What is Iman? To have faith in Allah, all God's books, all Allah's books. That means all Allah's, you know, wa malaikatihi, all Allah's angels, Gabriel, Israel, Israfil, wa kutubi, all Allah's books, the Quran al-Kareem, the Bible, the Torah, you know, the Injil, the Psalms, all four books of Allah, we believe in all. Wa rusulihi, all Allah's prophets, whether it may be Jesus, Moses, Abraham, Noah, Adam, Joseph, Isaac, Ishmael, Muhammad, we believe in all Allah's prophets. واليوم الآخر, and we believe in the last day of Qiyamah. والقدر خيره وشره من الله تعالى, and to accept and to believe that all good and bad, bitterness and sweetness, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والبعث بعد الموت, and to believe in life after death. آمنت بالله, to believe in Allah as he, you know, he is. كما هو بأسمائه وصفاته, with all his name, all his attributes, all his qualities. وقبلت جميع أحكامي, and we as Muslimin and Muslimin believe in all the commands of Allah as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on this. Now remember, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his pristine conduct was صالح الأمين. He was truthful in his life to such an extent. After becoming a Nabi, he goes to the Quraysh. Ya Quraysh, Ya Banu Hashim, Ya Banu, you know, Abd Manaf. He called unto them, come, come. When they come, what does he say? Would you accept if I tell you there is an army behind this mountain that is ready to attack you? What do they say? Ya Ahmad, Ya Muhammad, we'll believe you. You are Sadiq al-Amin, you are truthful. We'll definitely believe you. And thereafter, what does he say? Oh Quraysh, what if I tell you Allah is one, and I am the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Thereafter, what does Abu Lahab say? Just imagine, he was Sadiq al-Amin. Even before accepting Islam, they believed him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's akhlaq, his character, inshallah. We'll leave it there for today, inshallah. From myself, Hamaad Timol, inshallah, until we meet again. Remember the Twitter account, Hamaad 6, that's H-A-M-M, double A-D, number 6. You can follow us, inshallah, on Twitter account. Or you can like our Facebook page, inshallah. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us among those that will assist people, help people, and show people our noble character, inshallah. From myself, Hamaad Timol, inshallah, until we meet again. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.